So many social engagements, so little time.
I know, that's what we got. You loved it, I hate it.
You might have an issue with nostalgicism. Oh, don't remind me of the never-ending sock pile of mildew.
Hi, welcome to Comedy Parenting Radio, the only show that uses checkered tablecloths to do shot put measurements.
It's actually pretty effective. It works really well.
Well, except for when the shot put lands in the banana cream pie.
We have our little mascot here on the studio desk, the Tyrannosaurus Rex with the movable jaw. What do you think that he's thinking right now, Courtney?
I think he is wondering why we suddenly have a bunch of flies in here once Elijah took his boots off.
Release the killer flies.
I'd have to say he's wondering where his paycheck is for the last 4 years.
You gotta wonder about a show that makes people take their cowboy boots off before you do it.
Yeah, can we open a window in here?
Trust me, we know what we're doing.
You know, cowboy boots are like superpowers. Once you take them off, you really lose all ability to speak, think, or do anything.
So does everybody else around you. Today, we're going to be airing our dirty laundry.
On the air.
Stay tuned. This should be interesting.
Ranger Station, Ranger speaking.
Yeah, hi. I'd like to report a bear sighting.
Location?
In the woods, just outside of town.
Oh, not surprising. You've got your home. Bears have theirs.
Yeah, but see, this wasn't just any bear. This bear was wearing jeans and a hat, as in a Smokey Bear.
Jeans and a hat. That's definitely Smokey. What exactly did he have to say?
Well, we were about to head home, you know, after having a bonfire.
Oh, I can guess where this is going.
Right, right. See, Smokey told me the fire wasn't actually out. He said if it's too hot to touch, it's too hot to leave.
That's true. Did you know that 9 out of 10 wildfires are caused by humans? That means 9 out of 10 wildfires can be prevented.
Wow, no kidding?
I'm a forest ranger. We never kid.
Sorry.
that was a joke.
Oh.
If you see someone in danger of starting a wildfire, step in and make a difference, because 9 out of 10 wildfires are caused by humans. Brought to you by Smokey Bear, the U.S. Forest Service, your state forester, and the Ad Council. Learn more at SmokeyBear.com.
Only you can prevent wildfires.
You're listening to Comedy Parenting Radio.
Welcome back to Comedy Parenting Laundry.
We're airing it. That's radio.
Comedy Parenting Radio, airing our dirty laundry.
Boy, do we have laundry.
No, lots of laundry.
Lots and lots and lots of laundry.
You know how people joke about how their laundry's never ending?
Yeah.
It's no joke for us. There's literally laundry all the time.
We have that laundry that they talk about in multiple locations.
Yep. Times 10.
Upstairs, downstairs, sometimes hidden in the basement, in the cars. Not too much in the garage, because once the laundry makes it to the garage, it gets thrown away.
Yeah, it's trash. Outside, on the hillside?
I think I saw Josiah's Sunday collared shirt as a shop rag.
What? Dad, how could you do this to me? That was my favorite family heirloom.
Everything becomes a shop rag around here, eventually.
Oh boy, I can't even go on that side of the room, I'm sorry, but your feet really smell. Speaking of smells, let's talk about laundry smells.
The nice pine fresh or the nice laundry soap smells?
And I was thinking more like the smells that laundry make when people haven't hung it up for a couple days. It starts smelling like them, so you can smell the laundry and then track down who didn't hang up their own laundry.
Oh, don't remind me of the never-ending sock pile of mildew.
What is it with washing machine people? They never have advertisements where the wife or anybody in the family leaves the laundry in the machine for 3 days.
Because we are an exception, Dad.
hey, buy our Whirlpool washing machine and leave your laundry in there for 3 days with the lid closed.
I mean, I remember the first time that I actually got laundry to come out and actually smell nicely like laundry soap and oxy, and I thought it was a miracle. I wasn't sure what was happening.
You thought you were in another household. You know, there were times when I would be at work and someone would walk by and I'd go, I wish our laundry smelled like that.
I've done that too, actually.
I had a mother tell me one time, oh my goodness, all of the hockey laundry is just reeks. It's like hockey laundry is nothing compared to what we have.
I mean, you literally, after you do your laundry, you have to go take a shower.
Apparently they roll in their laundry before they put it in.
I mean, that stuff stings your eyes, man.
It depends on who it is that's doing their laundry load, right? With the boys, it's like radiation level smell. My clothes, it's all just smells like grease and oil and mechanical things.
I would like to point out that everybody is responsible for their own load of laundry. And does that work?
Not at all.
No.
It always goes into a mixed pile. And that never-ending sock pile of mildew, good-for-nothing, gum-chewing, bottom-of-my-shoe pile of socks.
Somehow, Josiah ends up doing laundry for all the brothers because he has this, like, homogenous thing where his laundry gets mixed in with everybody else's underneath the bed or something, like some special mixing place.
Well, the problem is that He has so much laundry all over the floor, and if Josh and I leave, like, literally one thing, it gets... And he goes and cleans it up and puts it all in one pile instead of sorting it back out, and so he just ends up doing a few of our things with his truckloads of laundry that he does each week.
You're listening to Comedy Parenting Radio, airing our dirty laundry. Stay tuned and grab a clothespin for your nose.
Listen up, it's philosophical. Mud grips, wide tip. Cigar sticking out of my face. Earnhardt Racing sticker on the window, banged up fender. 4x4 straight pipe roar. Primer and rust all over the door. Scarred up knuckles, mag belt buckle. White t-shirt, ain't afraid to work. Got a, what are you looking at?
Okay, forest animals. Kids are coming to the forest, and it's up to us to make their visit a good one. Sparrow, have you practiced the most popular bird songs for the year?
Of course.
Catchy. I like it. River, how's the temperature?
It's a refreshing 52 degrees, man.
I love it. Turtle.
He's not here yet, man.
He's late every morning. Okay. Squirrel.
The forest has been preparing just for you. To learn more about cool things to do in the forest, visit discovertheforest.org. Brought to you by the U.S. Forest Service and the Ad Council.
You're listening to Comedy Parenting.
Stop imitating Fezzik, and I mean it.
Does anybody want to do that?
Welcome back to Comedy Parenting Radio, airing our dirty laundry.
You have to climb up to the top of the laundry pile and drop the laundry into the volcano, which is the washing machine.
We've been talking about all the bad smells, but we haven't really been talking about the good smells.
I hate that new laundry soap.
Really? I love it.
I know. That's what we got. You loved it. I hate it.
Yeah, well.
I walked in the house and went, who spilled perfume all over in the house? It was one little teeny tiny load of laundry. Stunk up the whole house.
Well, there was that other old soap that I also did not like the smell of, but this new
that
soap...
That stuff was pretty good.
Yeah.
The original's good.
Well, anyway, besides the point, when your laundry actually comes out and then you hang it up outside, because we don't have a dryer up here, we hang all of our laundry up outside.
How long have we been doing that?
Forever, 10, 15, 20 years. All of our lives.
Well, yeah, we still have pants hanging up from 20 years ago outside.
Yep. And boy, do they smell good. There's nothing that really beats the smell of freshly hung, brought inside clothes after they're dried and you just smell like you're outdoors and you put your fresh sheets on your bed and in the nighttime when you're sleeping, you dream of that you're outdoors and doing something outdoors.
I mean, you know what they really need to do is they need to make a laundry detergent which smells like campfires, oil.
We could smoke your sheets. Build a campfire right next to the house and smoke your sheets.
I mean...
Nothing like the smell of fresh smoked sheets on your bed.
You want to know what's the best laundry detergent you could ever have? The best smelling?
What?
Fresh rain.
laundry detergent.
I don't think you can capture the smell of fresh rain.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I know.
You literally have to capture the rain inside of the jug and then put soap and whatever else into it, and then you get fresh rain.
Now, with rain molecules.
There are a lot of soaps which are like, that tell you that they smell like fresh summer's rain or something like that. And then you smell them, and they smell like the basement of a perfume factory.
Fresh rain smell is called petrichor.
Called what?
Petrichor.
Petrichor.
P-E-T-R-I-C-H-O-R.
Petrichor.
Sounds catchy for a soap name.
Wow, these fresh petrichor smelling sheets.
I mean, isn't it just wet ozone?
One of my newest things in my life is to wear a lot of black.
That's because you're getting larger, Dad, and black is a slimming color.
Thank you so much. But it doesn't work because of lint.
The lint.
I mean, that's literally all I've been wearing for the past several years is black.
Mm. And you're already slim. So, yeah, that's not a good look on you.
I mean, yeah.
You look like a skinny shadow.
You look like a flagpole shadow walking around.
Yep.
How many lint rollers do we own in our house?
Well, I personally have 6 in my drawer, so...
2 in the car. I mean,
2 in the car.
I mean, I...
4 in the closet that are all stuck together.
I mean, I unloaded that truckload last week.
2 more in the other closet that are unwrapped, but should be stuck together.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
But the thing is they don't really seem to work.
You have to take the paper off the outside before you start rolling.
Oh.
For our lint, it's, since it's up here in the mountains, it's a, tough wilderness lint. And so you need to get, like, the super glue, strength level.
It's true. I have the children stand on my clothes while I lint roll them so I don't come up with the super lint roller.
Basically, take the whole piece of cloth with you.
But, you know, there's so much lint on our clothes that it's like one swipe, the thing's full.
It probably takes us more time to lint roll our clothing than it does to wash them.
With our clothing, when you lint roll it, we'll reduce your thread count to about, I don't know, 24 after about 6 times.
And that's on corduroy. Another problem up here with our laundry is the fact that it gets hung outside to dry. Then we have wind.
Yeah, the wind is kind of an issue.
Now, it can blow two ways. It can blow the stuff onto the porch on the floor, or it can blow it off the porch out in the bushes, right?
Yep. How many clothespins would you normally say in a place that's not as windy as ours? How many clothespins would you say need to be put on a blanket to keep it on the line?
An average blanket?
Yeah.
Maybe 3.
Maybe 3.
Or 4.
How many do we need to put on our blankets to keep them on
like
the line?
Like really, truly, effectively?
Yeah.
15.
Yeah. It's just all one line of clothespins.
It is.
With 50 mile an hour winds, I mean, those blankets will go a ways.
I'll tell you what, Windwagon Smith would have been proud of the winds we have up here.
I mean, I think that I saw one of our neighbors walking around with your shirt last week.
On his face.
Yeah.
Actually, I come driving home from work, and our road is below our house. And I'm like, oh, there's something that blew off the porch down here onto the road.
Yeah, we've had some shirts disappear and show up a while later after we go explore the hillside.
I mean, and then you're down there digging in the dirt, and then you're like, what's this? An artifact? Nope, it's last week's laundry.
Like 3 years ago laundry.
It's so dangerous below our house that we don't go down there very often. So if something blows down there, a lot of times it'll just kind of stay there.
You have to get your harness and your rappel rope and rappel down to get the laundry.
I'm not going to do that for a sock. You're listening to Comedy Parenting Radio, airing our dirty laundry. Stay tuned.
Speak up, because you can. Your mind is a powerful tool, and so is your freedom of speech. So use it. It's what separates you from being a number to being an individual. Thoughts, beliefs, opinions, creativity. It's what makes you. Stand proud and say it loud. Know your rights. Know your freedom to speak. This message is brought to you by the National Association of Broadcasters, Education Foundation, and the Broadcast Education Association.
Captain, we got a problem. We hit a reef and we're sinking.
Shh, not now, not now. I'm listening to Comedy Parenting Radio.
Seems it never rains. Mountains in Southern California.
You're back with Comedy Parenting Radio, airing our dirty laundry. And so now you made an effort to wash something. Somehow it miraculously got out of the washing machine before 3 days, and it's hanging up on the line with 15 clothespins, except for somehow it gets ripped down by aliens and ends up on the porch floor. What happens next?
And then the cat ends up sleeping on the laundry.
That's what the lint roller's for. Which is really funny because we paid really good money to give her a really nice, like, soft, velvety cat bed.
She's got, like, a princess cat bed, like, about 5 feet away. And what does she sleep on?
The laundry.
Yeah.
Like my towel that is very uncomfortable to even touch.
Have you felt the towels lately?
They're literally sandpaper.
I was thinking, like, number three grit.
Nice exfoliating scrub.
Who needs to buy a Turkish bath? You can get scrubbed on by your own towel.
We might as well just use Brillo pads.
Let's tell everybody about how we put laundry away.
Well.
Okay, so there you go.
We don't. We bring it all inside and just...
Put it on the couch.
Put it on the couch. And then it just kind of shifts around on positions of the couch depending on where you want to sit on the couch.
No. Laundry goes on the couch. Laundry goes on the blue chair. Laundry goes on the rocking chair.
Yep. And if it ever does get put away, it tends to be, you fold the important people of the house, like Dad's laundry and Courtney's laundry, and then all the boys' laundry, you just chuck it in the room and, you know.
I think the boys take their clean laundry into their room, set it down on a charge of C4, and explode it all over their room. Clean.
Yep.
And it surprisingly stays folded.
No, it does not stay folded. It looks like a super volcano is in there.
You might have an issue with nostalgicism.
Yeah, nostalgicism.
You might have an issue with nostalgicism if you keep socks to remember stuff. Especially ones that are over 80% whole. We just wash them and then hope that the person that owns it will grab it. And then they never do, so we wash it again and hope that the next time it'll happen. And
I think you may have hit on a key thing in our family. We all live on laundry hope.
Yeah.
We hope it comes out clean. We hope it doesn't smell. We hope it doesn't have lint. We hope the cat doesn't want to sleep on it. And we certainly hope it doesn't blow off of the laundry line.
And that is why little brother has socks with holes that are 3 inches around.
You're listening to Comedy Parenting Radio, airing our dirty laundry. Now you know. Thanks for coming into the studio today, gang.
You're welcome.
You're welcome.
By the way, before you guys go...
Yeah.
Yes.
Would you please open up this new palette of lint rollers and clothespins?
That was not in the job description.
Bye-bye.
Side effects may include nausea, vomiting, dizziness, and possibly death. Batteries not included.